Some of the fondest memories of my childhood were woven around supper time. When my mother used to call from the back steps of the old home place, "Come on home now, son, it's supper time." Oh, gee, but I'd love to hear that again. But you know, for me, time has woven the realization of a truth.
Grandma was my friend, my confidant, my mother, my mother-in-law. You know, Grandma was a very amiable person. She's someone you can never be tired of staying in her company.
I used to call her mommy. Grandma happens to be the best mother-in-law so far. This woman gives me rest of mind. She gives me peace. Grandma won Nimila Rari for a day.
I'm so fortunate coming into this world through her because she was a woman of substance. She was a peaceful woman. She was a woman that everybody want her to be in her life. She was a cheerful giver, and I learned that from her. She can sacrifice anything for anybody at any time. And I'm always proud that at least I passed through into this world.
Home, come home, it's supper time. We're going home at last.
When you are talking about a rare breed, Grandma was privileged to be a rare product because she's not the kind of mother-in-law that put pressure on you. I had nothing when I met my wife. And she was not displeased, even with my status. She encouraged us to go into the marriage and she gave her full support. She gave us spiritual support and moral support. She was always available. So, Mama is a unique mother-in-law every man would desire to have as a mother-in-law.
My grandma was like everything. She was a mother for all. Mother for our children, for our grandchildren. She was just everything. Because she can sacrifice anything for anybody. She was very loving, jovial. Even as when she was becoming old, you see her 16 children down telling them stories and stuff. She was very, very lively and she was a great person.
Ah, I want to see me like my guinea bag on poor gun. Tori said, Grandma Baba, you want to leave until my daughter comes back. Jabai, she will be abusing my husband. Ha, agbaya niye, agbaya. Oh, loju ti. Omo to ye she ti bi she de. And my husband will be like, ah, she as in she ya ilo bi mi shada. The woman did not even support him, and I think that is how it should be.
She's a unifier between the Amola's family and Arogo's family. She's somebody everybody respects a lot.
One funny experience I remember that I had with her was, okay, she did not know that my mom already gave me an instruction to go to the pot to take meat. So her coming into the kitchen, it was as if I was stealing meat. So she was already like, she was already trying to correct me in a way that I would not feel bad. But that was one thing I liked about her. She did not just rebuke me. She tried to understand the situation and all.
She normally comes to my house in Ibadan. She plays with my children. We talk one-on-one. We rub her together. Most of the time she comes, I give her time.
There are a lot to say about Grandma. Because she's a very caring, attractive, wonderful grandma. She's a very, very, she's a lovely person in which everyone loves to have around her.
I'm going to miss her so much. She was such a loving mother. She was everything to me. Is it the advices she gave me when she was alive, or the tolerance that she taught me how to deal with, or how to cool, how to be calming down?
I miss her stories, her jovial lifestyle, and everything I learned from her. I've learned a lot of things from her. So like, she dying now is a great sadness for me.
There are several for the experiences. Several for, you know, most of the experiences are like when she was old. Whenever she comes to our house in the Ibadan to visit us, if Mama spent like 1 week, maximum of 2 weeks, I'm going home. mo fe lo say to awon eyan as in a lot of things.
Mama Mola, we really miss her because of her contribution. She was so humble, so gentle, and so kind to everyone that caught across her path.
Many things, plaiting her hair, her stories, different things. I'll miss everything about her. She's a very great personality.
Grandma, Mama miss Efo. She used to prepare Efo for me. She used to prepare me Efo, Ewuro, Efo, Bagba, pelu rice atewa. Mami is on jeun. Mami is iwa irele won.
If I will miss virtually everything about her, she was a good cook. She's somebody that whenever you're speaking with her, you'll be very happy, you'll be very glad because she's a soft-spoken and she smiles a lot. She doesn't get angry anyhow.
I'm sure gonna miss her. I'm sure gonna miss her because she was everything to me. She was so dear to me.
I would just advise everybody that if everybody can behave like my mom, because she was a supportive wife to her daddy. In fact, she was a prayerful woman to us with the children. She's a lovable woman.
Shadows come, then winding down an old familiar pathway. I'd hear my mother call at set of sun. Come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen past. Come home, it's supper time. We're going home at last.
The funnest part of it ni pe mama yi o support daddy wa o support won nigba tin kan ku die ka to o se gbogbo n toto ati n to ye
mama yi o dara lopolopo o je abi amo toto o je eni olufokansin o je en to ko ebi ara ati iye kan mara o de to je eni to gba jesu gege bi oluwa ti oludande re
ya to toju omo to toju oko ya to so gbogbo awon omo to so gbogbo awon omo pe baba ni ka fa take care in character resemble her physically I resemble her in everything I resemble her even the act of giving I take after her
ari eko ko pupo lara momo sugbon eko ti emi ri ko julo ni pe momo ologbon ni won won de ni suru gan abi amo to to si ni won won yi da omo laamu won yi de bi laamu won de ma ngbegbe aye alafia pelu gbogbo eniyan.
I don't know who can replace my mom. I can't just say who can replace my mom because I so much like her.
Sabina Orele o Orele o are ma po bilawi Orele o eh Orele o are ma po. Mama Grace Taiwo Rejiremi o Ayara Depojo Orele o Sabaina Oluwayemi Simi Ayamola Mama Reverend Adegunle o Mama Kulukemi Mama Vola Shade o Mama Romolola Mama Sunday Mama Romotola Mama Rabayo Mimi o. I want you to know.
ọ̀rẹ́ lọ.